Hi, welcome to another Macworld video. I'm Chris Breen. You know, as it turns out, the Apple TV is not Apple's best set-top media player. As a matter of fact, this Mac Mini is a far more flexible and capable player. The hitch is that when you connect a Mac to a television, you still face the difficulty of controlling it from the couch. Fortunately, if you have an iPod Touch or an iPhone, you can easily solve that problem with one of the inexpensive applications I'm about to show you. If you have an Apple remote control, the $5 Remote Pro will look familiar to you. In one view, it provides you with controls very much like the Apple hardware controller. One advantage it has over the hardware controller is that you can tap the Applications button at the bottom of the screen and launch the media apps that you'd like to control with your iPhone or iPod Touch. Like the other remotes I'll discuss, this one also includes a trackpad and keyboard emulator. With it, you can move your Mac's cursor around the screen. A double tap works like a double click, and you can right-click just by placing two fingers on the trackpad and then lifting your fingers. The keyboard displays the iPhone's normal keyboard plus an F key keyboard, as well as the Command, Option, and Control modifier keys. Simple, straightforward, easy to use. The $3 Air Mouse Pro has its virtual trackpad and keyboard too. Additionally, it includes separate controls for F keys and modifier keys, as well as a screen for controlling a media player such as iTunes and another for controlling your web browser. It also includes buttons for invoking expose and left and right click, and the server application lets you assign key commands to its F key, media, and web buttons. Snatch, a $4 app from Hoofian, has a variety of talents. Like the other remote apps, Snatch has a virtual trackpad and keyboard. That keyboard offers both the standard iPhone keyboard as well as a function key keyboard. There's also a separate scrolling screen. As its name implies, you use it to scroll windows up and down and side to side. Snatch will also launch and switch apps on the Mac it's connected to. One of its most intriguing features is the ability to create buttons for controlling your Mac. For example, I can create a new button, assign the Command comma keyboard shortcut to it, and then tap that button whenever I want the currently active application to show its preference window. If you like, you can download some pre-configured remotes from Hoofier's website and then install them on your iPhone or iPod Touch. And then there's the $5 Hippo remote. Unlike the other remote applications, Hippo remote doesn't require a server application to be running on your Mac. Just enable remote management within the sharing system preference and you're good to go. Hippo Remote also has its trackpad, keyboard complete with F keys and arrow keys, and ability to control a variety of applications. It includes a couple of other unique features that I also like. One is the scrolling feature. Just call up the trackpad and rotate your finger around the screen. A virtual wheel appears on the screen that acts as a scroll control. Also, the keyboard remembers what you've typed in a keyboard history. Just tap one of these history entries to type that bit of text. And when you call up the OS X profile and tap the More button, you can create a macro. Just enter the keystrokes you want Hippo Remote to send, save your command, and then tap it when you want to invoke that command. And there you have it, four remote control applications for your iPod Touch or iPhone, each with their special talents. Altogether, they cost $17, so collect them all. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you around.